Hello and welcome to round number 5, matchup number 2, version 1 is with me, and we are going
Hello.
to review the matchup between the Robber Barons and
But before we do that,
Hurricanes.
But before we do that, I have a shout-out to make.
Stop screaming.
Yeah, are you ready? So we had some problems with the music, because every head-to-head, or a lot of head-to-head parks have music, so I'm gonna do a little advertisement here for Trigger's Music Manager. I found it on the Rollercoaster Tycoon Reddit. It's a tool where you can basically have a library of the songs in that you use in RCT, and then set it into the custom 1 and custom 2 slot. So, interesting tool, I would say.
Well, I didn't fully understand what it actually does.
Basically,
but, okay,
you have a library with the songs, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then you can mark the song and click set as custom 1, and then it's automatically set into custom 1.
Okay.
But this, you know, the song in the library is still called the original song. So you could basically call it, for example, the Star Wars theme or the Morrow World music, and then go into Trigger's Music Manager, and, you know,
okay,
it's way easier that way.
Okay.
But
back to the park. The reason we stopped, or I paused the park, is because of random explosions of random explosiveness. To be honest, the park doesn't have any readmes, and I'm really confused about what it should be. It reminds me a little bit of Fallout. Version 1 says it looks like Mad Max.
It's basically a Mad Max park. It's a Mad Max park that's completely different. Well, not completely, but a little bit different to the other Mad Maxes.
Okay.
I mean, you have the classic things like this huge car chase fight thingy at the beginning,
yeah.
and of course the Thunderdome the Bumper Dome in the closed theme park.
Okay.
If this is very interesting. 4D coaster, which is really weird. Yeah. If you're not saying anything, then I will say something.
Yeah, I'm just...
Because it's not really hacked together, but they made parts of the 4D track invisible and built B&M track there instead.
Yeah, or... my train track.
Yeah, or my train track. And it really doesn't really work as coaster because there are no brakes at the end.
Yeah. And there are bandits putting the coaster structure down.
Yeah, well, that's not that important. Like, the coaster structure seems very solid. My screen. So, yeah, I think the best part of this park is this theme park. So I guess it's kind of the same story as with Mad Max, that this is a huge world that is kind of turned into a desert planet with, you know, the global warming.
Yeah.
Raged on, and so this theme park has basically disappeared under sand, like this.
Okay.
the Ferris wheel is, I think, clearly.
Yep, that's very clear.
And to be in a sandstorm.
I just want to say I really love the Ferris wheel.
Yeah, the Ferris wheel is, I think,
awesome.
The best thing of this park.
I like the big cage,
the bumper dome.
The bumper dome. That looks cool.
Yeah, the tower. I mean, as I said, I really like the theme park.
Yeah.
I don't like the city too much. I guess the idea behind the coaster is that it was a different layout, but they filled in the rest with these mine tracks.
Yeah.
But it's still strange that they wouldn't add a brake before the station. Like, if you want to run a roller coaster, Make it so that you don't die in a turn.
Yeah, but okay. I actually like this city.
Oh, it's technically.
It's a bit dull, but on the other side, I mean, it's basically a abandoned kind of city, and they usually look fucked up and stupid.
I never liked cities in RCT. Oh, no.
Yeah, you don't like boats too, so.
Yeah, but you know, cities are just these huge buildings with, you know, they are not really eye pleasing in my eyes.
Yeah.
And I don't know, like, I only have watched the newest Mad Max, and I really love how the society is really completely, you know, vanished from the face of the earth. And in this case, you know, this big city is just a little bit. So yeah, I like the park. There's a lot of free space,
which is unusual.
Unusual, and I'm not the biggest fan of it because it just seems gimmicky. This huge space with nothing in it was used for the opening chase, and since then there's like
nothing
just a huge.
There.
Space without anything happening.
Yeah. So if you miss the opening chase, you might think they just weren't able to finish the park.
Yeah. And it's, you know, the, like, that's like the thing. The overall impression of this park is just like the city is not really. There's nothing going on in the city. There's nothing going on in this huge plane. Like even in this survivors camp or something, what there should be, not. Much going on. Everything that's going on in any way is in the theme park.
Yeah. You could say that.
So I don't know. Like it's not perfect for that park, I think. Especially when there's no readme, so you don't really know the story of the city and the theme park and everything.
That's what I think a readme would have done that really, really good.
Yeah.
But okay, so that's that. Make sure to download the park. Nonetheless, check it out in game. I think it's worth a look. But let's move on to the next park, I would say. Shall we? We shall.
Yes. Let's get fucked by Gamer.
Let's get fucked by Gamer. Okay. We could sing the theme so the gamer doesn't recognize it.
Oh, we have to talk over it like constantly, I think.
Okay.
It should work.
Da-da. Like what so the bloody fuck?
Like, okay.
I changed
have
it.
Have you loaded it?
Yeah, I changed it, but it didn't. Yeah, well, it fucked itself, basically. So, Star Wars. After years of peace, the Galactic Empire.
The best park in the world!
Shut the fuck up. The Galactic Empire blah 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 re-emerged and taken.
Has re-emerged and taken hold of Hoth, Jevon 4, Tatooine, Coruscant and the first moon of Endor. Luke Skywalker and his friends have been captured by the vile gangster Jabba the Hutt, and signs of the Sith have loomed near the Jedi Temple of Coruscant. Will you be able to help our heroes overcome the Empire?
Of course we will.
It's really hard to read. But the Star Wars...
But the problem is you go into the theme park and you... They say you should help them, but you can't read what you should do.
But in the theme park you could read it, like... I mean...
Okay, I guess so.
I mean, even you can read it, like... It's not impossible to read, it's just hard to read. And
I can't read it.
For diagonal text, this is quite impressive.
Okay, so as you might see or hear, this park is based on Star Wars.
It's the best park ever.
This may be the second best park.
That's
ever.
My favorite.
If someone would do a really good Lord of the Rings park, I would totally.
Like honestly, I'm gonna say this before everything else. It's clear for who I'm gonna vote. This is my favorite Hedgehog Park. I had, and I legitimately had, this is American Waterfront as my wallpaper for a couple of weeks. But this park is my favorite Hatred park of all time. So,
if you say so,
I'm not even gonna leave it open for who I'm gonna vote here, because I don't know. I have literally no reason to vote for Borrowland in this scenario.
Okay, but let's look at the park. Okay.
Okay. The first thing you see in the park is the fucking Death Star shooting a laser at you, and that's awesome.
That's quite impressive.
Yeah.
And the second thing you see is the Millennium Falcon.
Yeah, and yeah, the Millennium Falcon and the TIE Fighter, or I guess no, it's not the TIE Fighter, it's the TIE Bomber. At least it's called like that in
which one are you referring to?
The left one from the entrance. That's the TIE Bomber, I guess, or TIE Interceptor. I don't know.
Entrance, like
if you go into the entrance, the Death Star, left of the right of it is the X-wing.
Yeah.
From Luke Skywalker. And left of it is
the TIE
whatever from Darth Vader in the movie.
Yeah, I didn't notice that.
Yeah, so let's just talk about Entrance Plaza, I think, a bit more before we
do it.
Oh, because the entrance of the Stormtrooper, what's called Stormtrooper Academy, the Death Star, is done with a Imperial Star Destroyer, which is really nicely done, I think.
Yep.
That's so, right. Yeah, nice entrance plaza. I think it's really cool how the Death Star is set up with the path under it. Like, although it's a Star Wars park, it still feels like a real theme park, if you know what I mean. That's something that I really like about it.
Oh god, Cantina Band.
Yeah, at the left.
I just died.
Yeah, the left. Let's go from left and then to the big circle. On the left, of course, is Mos Eisley on the remote planet of Tatooine. It's always funny because it's the remote planet of Tatooine, but every movie has some part, or almost every movie has some parts in it. Yeah, and of course the first thing you see is the Millennium Falcon with Chewie and Han Solo as a meet and greet at the exit of the ship itself.
Oh, yeah, I didn't notice them.
Yeah, so the ship, I think it's well done for RCT. It's always hard to build round ships in RCT round objects in RCT. So, but you can.
I think honestly, all the ships in this park are done quite well. All the spacecrafts and.
But of course, Millennium Falcon is like the hardest spacecraft in Star Wars to do in RCT, just because of the form of the ship itself. Like the X-wing. I mean, if you look at the X-wing, it's really well done. But X-wings are pretty. No, they are not really round in any capacity. So yeah, you enter through this quest ship that you see in the movies in Tatooine, and you enter Mos Eisley, and again, not really a fantasy park. So this Mos Eisley has the Sarlacc pit in it, and the two suns behind the Sarlacc pit, which is a nice detail. It has the Watto's junk shop from episode 1, which is a nice detail. The Toshi station, of course. Like, that's just a nerd fest. This park is a nerd fest. Like, if you like Star Wars, you will just love this park.
Just one quick thing. I'm not pointing out whatever version 1 is saying, because I have no idea which is what. Okay.
The Sarlacc pit is the top spin.
Please don't. If my mouse is on something while version 1 is saying something, just ignore it, because it's probably wrong.
So, behind the top spin are the two suns. I hope you can point them out, because Tatooine has two suns.
Ah, now I see it. Okay.
Really important detail. The Sarlacc pit is of course this monster in on Tatooine.
Yeah.
You have this speeder getting pulled through the speeds, which, again, throwback to episode 4, where you see that happening. You have Uncle Owen's and Aunt Beru's farm, which is, I think, really nice. like the small
yeah I found
small
that
structure
by accident.
And of course the only good thing coming from episode one besides Ewan McGregor is Obi-Wan Kenobi. You have the arena of the pod racing, and pod racing is awesome. And you have a Rancor fighting Luke Skywalker there, because why not? Why not have everything there?
And you have a sexy Jabba slave girl.
Yeah.
In a Jabba, pod racer.
Jabba's got the sexiest slave girls. Yeah, but pod racers. The pod race scene is really cool. I like how they built it in this park. And I think the arena is really well done.
That's true.
And does the movie justice. This whole, yeah, I really like this whole area. Let's not forget the if you go back to the entrance, this huge brown Java sandcrawler. I think it's one of the coolest things in the movie, or one of the cooler. Everything is cool in the original movie, so. And of course, besides this sandcrawler, is Slave One, the ship of Boba Fett, which also really awesome. Man, I love it. I love everything about it. It's so great.
Hey, I found it. Woo.
Woo.
I'm so good at this.
Yeah.
I'm sorry if I'm not saying much, but Bergman is just so much more into Star Wars than me, so he probably knows everything and I don't know shit, so I let him do the talking.
I bet I overlooked some things, but you know, this park is just so full of details, because Star Wars is a world full of details. Especially since it's like, yeah, you have three movies, so you have to get everything you can out of these three movies. And yeah, let's go out of Tatooine into Hoth, the ice planet, with the first big coaster that we got to see. It is called Echo Base Snowspeeders, which makes sense, because that's like
the beginning
of the fifth episode, with the battle against the AT-ATs or the Imperial Walkers, which is really, really fantastic. Like this AT-AT just looks great. Again, it's a good thing that the Empire uses a lot of doesn't use a lot of circles or a lot of round things. I forget. I don't know the word of for it being, you know, eckig. You would say in German. And you know, the snow base is really, really big, but I like it.
Yeah, it's really cool. Really well done.
And you know, you really have the feeling of an ice planet with everything going on. And I would just imagine this to be a great, great themed area for this park if it was real. The coaster I actually liked. There was some critic on, or some negative responses to it and on the board. But I really don't know why, because I think it's a well done layout with a lot of airtime, with a lot of fun turns.
I mean, it's nothing special, but it's basically first of all, it's in head-to-head, right? And it's obviously in a fantasy park, and so fuck off. I mean, we had way, way, way worse layouts in this head-to-head.
Yeah, and I remember how Giga World was actually praised in the comments. So I know that these are maybe not the same people, but you know, if Giga World would get braced, then this should be, you know, called the best coaster ever.
Maybe not. Let's move on.
Yeah, let's move on into the next world. Of course, it is the forest moon of Endor. the final part of episode 6, with, of course, the first thing you see is the Imperial shuttle, which is amazingly done.
True.
And the ATTEs of course, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I had a mistake there for 2 seconds. That's dangerous in the Star Wars community. And with another coaster, I would say. The Ender speeder bikes, of course, again, throwback to the movie. And I think it's really well done. Like, if you know the movie,
it's really fun.
It looks fun, and you have this interesting concept of two coasters that get launched a little bit in different spaces, so the speed of them is always a little bit different, which is really cool. And you know, you have the Ewoks, the little Ewoks, and the overall, yeah, shoutouts for doing Ewoks CSOs. That's amazing. And you know, it capsules the movie very well, I think.
I guess so, yes. At least it captures very well what I remember of the movie, which is not much, but it's something.
So yeah, this the burning ATT is pretty awesome at the edge of the map.
Yeah.
But let's go to the next area, because there are a lot of areas that you have to talk about. So going towards the middle is a really small area that's called Dagobah. That is Dagobah.
The middle.
With this swamp.
Oh, the swamp. Okay,
I don't think there is a direct path between. Well, there is a underground path, but you know, let's go through Dagobah before we go to Gemin 4, which is of course the fourth moon of Gemin, as far as I'm aware. Yeah, but Dagobah is basically the planet where Yoda lives.
Well, I'm so good.
With the X-wing in the swamp, which is a really nice detail. A small area, but you know, the planet doesn't give much of, you know, you can't do much of a swamp planet. That's basically just swamp everywhere. And I think it's well done here.
Yep.
There's swamp bumper boats. Dagobah perils.
I really like it that they didn't stretch it too much, because if they would have done it too big, then the swamp would have really gotten boring.
This way it's
just the right size.
It's a nice transitional area, I think. Yeah. And that's like the thing about if you do licensed parks, like normally it's just like, what's the point of this small area between two areas, like if you do a normal theme park? But in this case, it's like, yeah, that's awesome, that's Dagobah. It doesn't offer much, but you know, as a small area, it's really cool. So let's go to Gemin 4 with, I think, my favorite coaster, which is the X-Wing Death Star Assault in the huge temple of Gemin 4. I think that's really well done, and again, this is a thing that makes me think this is more of a realistic park than a fantasy park.
Yeah.
Because you know, it makes sense, theme park wise. And you have great things like this the TIE fighter fighting against the Y-wing.
Mm.
The slightly smaller Millennium Falcon, which makes it a little bit better, I think, because again, if you build something smaller, it's easier to make it mount. You have Darth Vader's fighter, and of course the defending towers and all that stuff. It's just an awesome ride overall, with a lot of ships built into it, and I think it would be amazing to ride.
Yeah,
and of course the setup of the ride itself, I think, is pretty cool.
That's true, I guess.
For an indoor coaster, that's really well done. So
the wooden white mouse is working, isn't it? Yeah, it's working.
Yeah, wooden white mouse is, I think, it's a German for defense force. I don't really know what you would do with it. I guess it should be maybe a shooting ride. Shooting dark ride, I don't know.
Yeah, looks like it.
It's a little bit like it, yeah. With again, a lot of cool things like the ATT and the crashed shuttle lying in the middle, and the all the laser beams just awesome in this park. So
but the shuttle is not crashed.
Is it?
No. If you mean the same.
Oh yeah. Crash
shuttle,
yeah.
Then it's not crashed.
Yeah, I was a little bit confused because I thought it was a Imperial shuttle, but
it wasn't.
Yeah. Well, it is an Imperial shuttle, but.
Yeah, but it wasn't crashed.
Because they were stopped. Yeah. I was startled a little bit because it didn't have wings.
So, let's move forward. This is Coruscant. Coruscant.
Yeah, Coruscant. With build your own lightsaber, because of course you would have something like this in your park.
Yeah.
It's a little bit like the wand thing in Harry Potter. You just have to have it.
It's called wand.
Wand. Yeah. The wand. And
it,
of course,
has nothing to do with walls, you know.
And of course the Jedi Temple with the dark, with the Harry Potter and the Forbidden Journey-esque dark ride that, well, it doesn't work, but you know, you can't really make it work. Nasty, I think. Like these robo-coaster, robotic arm things. Yeah,
but I like it.
Yeah, I think...
Even if it's not working, I really like it.
It's really well built. With the scene of the Emperor fighting against Yoda and Obi-Wan for, you know... I wouldn't say for some reason, because, it's explained in the opening crawl, basically, that you know, this is a bit of a fantasy thing where it's all back to, you know, war, basically. And, you know, you have this fight, which is, I guess, cool, with the force lightnings that the Emperor shoots, I guess. Darth Sidious! That's wrong. It's Darth Sidious with a second eye. I have to fix that. And, yeah, the Coruscant area is maybe the only one that I find a little bit lackluster, because, yeah, I'm not totally convinced by the decision to build it into the park. First of all, everything else of this park is based on the old episodes. I mean, some things in Tatooine are from the new ones, but you know, Tatooine itself comes from the old ones. Oh. And you know, Coruscant is just a little bit strange in there. And the problem is that Coruscant is a city that's basically has so high buildings that you can't really see the ground, and there's no light and or anything reaching the ground and stuff.
Mm.
So and it has all these different levels, and it's really hard to convey this in RCT. Or yeah, maybe it's even impossible if you don't have random holes in them in the ground. So I would have preferred another planet, I guess. Yeah, I
would have preferred it, but it's not there.
Yeah, there are not that many other planets. Cloud City would have been... Like, Cloud City, again, wouldn't have been really doable, I guess, because of... Well, it's a city in the clouds. How would you build it in a realistic, quote-unquote, theme park? So, yeah, but I like the Bespin... the orange Bespin spaceship. That's a cool touch.
Oh, that's, yeah.
But again, I like the area. Not as much as the other areas, but it's still well done. And yeah, I mean, that's the whole park, I guess.
Yeah, we just took like 500 minutes on it, but okay.
I mean, it's the best park ever, so.
Yeah, you should really... I said you should download the park like in every park so far, but this one is really worth it. I'm not sure if I would think it's better than this is where Waterfront, just because I'm not that much into Star Wars, but it's definitely worth more than one look. You definitely download it.
Yeah, download it, and you know, there's so much.
Even if you don't have LCT2, just download it.
There's so much in this park that we couldn't, you know, analyze, because there's just so much going on.
Yeah.
Like, have you seen the scoreboard in the pod racing thing?
Yeah, I did.
But it's really interesting. I would have liked to have more inside names in there, Because, I mean, if you look at it, Chewbacca, Han Solo, Darth Vader, Sebulba, it's Boba Fett, Lando Calrissian, Luke Skywalker, and the Rancor. There could be some more inside name, like Wedge Antilles, or Grand Moff Tarkin, or something like that. That would have been funny. But, you know. You can't have everything.
Certainly can't. So, and with the lovely sound of the Katina band, I would say we stop now. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see each other again for matchup number 3 in a couple of days. So, goodbye.
Goodbye.